Hi, my name is Sandrine Dubracht and I am Associate Professor at the Medical University of Innsbruck, Austria. I am delighted to present you this work entitled Patients with Atopic Dermatitis Show Increased Clonal Hematopoiesis and Risk of Hematological Cancer, which is the result of the collaboration with the Department of Human Genetics of the Medical University of Innsbruck. So, atopic dermatitis is the most common chronic inflammatory skin disease worldwide, with a yearly prevalence of 2 to 36% in children and of 1 to 18% in adults. And this incidence has increased by 2 to 3 fold during the past decades in industrialized countries. At the cellular level, atopic dermatitis is characterized by a Th2 inflammation and impaired epidermal barrier function. Moreover, atopic dermatitis is associated with various atopic comorbidities such as allergic asthma, but also with blood malignancies, especially lymphoma. So, in the current study, we thought for early markers of hematological malignancies in patients with atopic dermatitis. We screened patients and healthy individuals for clonal hematopoiesis of intermediate potentials, shortened as CHIP, a condition that resembles a pre-malignant state of hematological diseases. Indeed, CHIP is defined as the presence of one or more somatic pathogenic variants in genes commonly altered in hematological disorders, with more than 2% variance allele frequency in the peripheral blood of individuals without evidence of hematological malignancy, dysplasia, or unexplained cytopenias. Furthermore, CHIP is associated with a 0.5 to 1% risk of progression to leukemia per year. So, in this work, we isolated genomic DNA from the blood of 75 patients with atopic dermatitis and 36 healthy subjects for the identification of CHIP-associated variants. DNA samples were analyzed by massively parallel sequencing using a hybridization capture enrichment-based sequencing approach. The gene panel for enrichment is of custom design and covers a range of 153 genes associated with malignancies, 97 of which are predominantly involved in myeloid and lymphoid neoplasms and their precursors. Our data show that CHIP is significantly increased in patients with atopic dermatitis, increasing in frequency from 2.8% in healthy individuals to 26.7% in patients. Most of the identified CHIP mutations can be classified as lymphoid CHIP. Furthermore, our data indicate that CHIP is present in patients of all ages with an average age of 33 years, but with the highest prevalence occurring between the ages of 24 and 26. In these young patients, CHIP primarily targets the KMT2C gene. Another interesting finding of this study is the inverse correlation between CHIP and disease severity. We found that patients with mild symptoms had higher levels of CHIP. Furthermore, an increased risk of CHIP was observed in patients treated with topical calcineurin inhibitors, suggesting that systemic immunosuppressive therapy is not the cause of CHIP. So, these data show increased lymphoid CHIP in patients with atopic dermatitis. CHIP occurs in young patients and is associated with treatment involving topical calcineurin inhibitors. And despite the limitation of this study, this work should encourage close follow-up of patients with atopic dermatitis and prompt further research to develop preventive interventions. Thank you for listening.